that is true. More tear gas. They ran up to the front of the bridge barricade and just launched a couple tear gas canisters and then went back. Unclear what that was about. But they are repositioning this line here. They just went in a different staggered formation, getting their orders. It's about 8 militarized cop with riot shields, flanked on each side by less lethal shotguns, and then a good handful of blue uniforms behind them. I don't know what that was for, but you saw, I don't know if you guys saw in the footage, the guy just casually launched a flashbang tear gas canister right there. Again, is that freelance photographer the police have brought with them. Again, I've never seen police with a freelance photographer before. The only reason I can assume they would do that is for some other legality purposes where, like, Dapple can get their hands on the photos. They could use it for other types of listings outside of the police's own legal use. Typically, they have police with their own police photographers and videographers. Again, this is a new one for me. might be for the police's own PR struggle they're dealing with online. They think they're the arbiters of truth. They're the cops. Officer pointing people out, about to fire at someone. Officer right there has the gun. The guy to the right of him was pointing at somebody, then he now just dropped the gun again. Now he seems to be aiming over in this direction. The militarized guys moving back with their shields. Where they were before they rushed up and just lobbed tear gas canisters over the barricade initially while I was taking a break. Yeah, they do actually watch the live feed, so you're onto something. When we were in Ferguson, live streamer Bassam actually caught the police in their police cruiser watching his live feed as he was streaming. Trying to get some kind of reaction to justify further gassing and shooting of people. Thank you.
Penalty vote forward. Get ready. Penalty vote forward. All right.
Yeah. for police, I can't see where they are talking to one person blind. Kind of like they did two nights ago where they shot and arrested people 2 hours later and decided, oh, maybe we could chat. They're talking to somebody at the front. They did this two nights ago. Try to make a negotiation with one person. Nobody speaks for a big group like this. Lengthy talk with a single person at the front line.
I'm
trying to see him.
Yeah, he's like
right there through the razor wire.
Huh?
Still talking to one lone individual on the front line. Again, they did this two nights ago. They made what they considered negotiations for people to leave with one person who does not speak to the entire group. That night, the cops prayed with some water protectors. Some people still lingered after that, but that's their choice. Because in a militarized structure like the police are, they just can't understand the difference between a leaderless grassroots movement and a military-style structure, hierarchical police force. If anybody watched any of my feeds from Ferguson, you know negotiating with police never does anything, because really the only chip that is a win for any protesters or water protectors is to release people from jail. I don't know if anyone's been arrested tonight, so we don't have that to negotiate with. And even then, they've never gone through with their promises of releasing people if the protesters left, like in Ferguson. It happened multiple times, so you never trust the cops in general, but especially a negotiation. One cop might negotiate something, doesn't mean his commanding officer might not go with that. The quote-unquote negotiations are over. Cops going back to their cave again. Where they were when I was down on a break, and that's when they decided, before I went back up live, to just rush up, toss canisters. They have people standing on the barricade over here. When I got back up live, I got on the left side of the bridge here, and they did it again. The officer came right up, dropped nonchalant. Actually, a little bit's 11:40. Thank you.
Liam. Thanks for joining. Concrete barrier of the bridge. Literally, my feet like can't go in any direction, or I'm stuck in razor wire.
Why is it all crazy?
The negotiators with their paid scum of a photographer. Not a police photographer, by the way. They've got a freelance photographer filming them tonight. Filming to us tonight, I should say.
ended.
Say to your comment, Luba, yes, there are some outstanding human beings in law enforcement, but if they were on the line ordered to fire at people, they would. And that's the point. It's not the individuals, it's the force. There are no individuals behind a uniform. That's the whole point of wearing a uniform. And the quote-unquote good cops you're talking about have no power to speak up or not do their job, so that's the problem they're facing. But the surveillance plane is going right overhead right now. No lights. That's what they do. Except when my feed's down and we're trying to sleep, they'll be flying those planes over our heads, right over camp, very low, all night long. That's what they've been doing the past 3 to 4 nights. Again, ramping that back up. They like to punish people. Whenever there's an action, they like to really just fly all night long, real low. Just to fuck with people, because that's what the kind of people we're dealing with. Lou was saying my feet cuts out when the plane goes over. We have heard that
not only has police and military used their Stingray devices from low-lying aircraft like that, we're pretty confident they do have the Stingrays and using them in those low-lying aircraft. So that would make sense. I don't know exactly how many feet they fly over low at night, but low enough that, you know, the small prop jet plane pretty much rattles the entire structure that you're in. Wake you up if you're already asleep.
Yeah.
people, you guys are having a problem commenting. Once it reaches a certain threshold of viewers, I don't know what it is on Facebook, but once you get into hundreds to thousands of viewers, it does lock people out of commenting every now and again for brief periods of time, just to keep the feed from being overwhelmed. Something that I've done to sometimes alleviate that, you can refresh your browser, that might bring you into the chat, or just wait, be patient, it should kick back in at some point, it'll lock other people out and let you in. Nobody has control over that. I think it's all done by algorithms. So cold out here, the shields are icing up. Cops now in a couple of large circles, possibly getting orders, regrouping. Spotlights. Thank you.
Thank you.
Huddling up again. On both sides now, enacting some kind of strategy. All right, tweet this out, folks. Here they come. Send us out. All the this is a shit ton of militarized troopers with full shields and the back taking the front. Got 20 on the left flank, 20, 30 more on the right flank. You got the snow cats coming in. They're being surrounded on both flanks at this point. The cops enacting some sort of plan. Nothing has been going on for hours. There's no justification for this at this point.
Get a light over there! Get the people over there. Get a line over there.
The military cops, possibly National Guard right here in the bridge. The cops went around to the left and the right flank. It's about 30 of them with some of the snowmobiles and track vehicles over here on the left flank. I'm sure it's similar on the right flank. And they're moving in. They're now on our side of the barricade at this point.
You're in
firing on people for no reason at this point.
Go back to your camp!
Come on, guys.
You are on sovereign territory!
They're now just taking pot shots at people.
Go back to your camp, you! Go back to your camp! Go back to your camp!
They're on sovereign territory at this point. Shit! Fuck! They're hit. They just stay into my fucking camera, you fucking assholes! Ah, shit!
Oh, no.
Medic! Medic!
Where?
Go!
They broke. I have a broken finger right now, folks.
I want to land right here. Shield,
right now. I got hit in the leg and the hand.
Come on.
My finger's definitely broken at this point.
Oh, shit.
Move it. Hey,
medic!
Let him through. Over the wall!
Tear gas fired. Starting to feel in my finger now. It's very painful. Got hit with some kind of heavy gauge, less lethal. Right in my leg. And then at my hand that was on my camera. Medic! I need a medic! I'm pretty sure my finger's broken. Ah, shit, my leg. Fortunately, it's cold. I can't feel my finger too much right now. My pinky is definitely broken.
Do you know where medic is?
If you guys can see this shit right there, take a screen cap of that shit. They hit me right.
To the front! Wake up! Get the fuck out of here!
Okay. They just charged people for no reason at this point, started attacking us for no fucking reason. Things were quiet for hours. I'm gonna take the feed down so I can get some medical treatment, guys. Please wish me luck. Megan?
Yeah?
Can you hit finish?
Okay. Hold on.